Hello, my name is Anthony Madonna. I was an engineer during the Apollo era. I was going through Kansas and I ran into this museum, and it is an excellent display of an Apollo spacecraft. It's Apollo 13, and what's neat about it, you can look into the hatch and see everything inside of it. It's very unusual to see that close up of Apollo.
We're in Kansas, and this is the some kind of space center. We're by the planetarium, and there's Joy. What's the name of this place, Joy?
The Cosmosphere in Hutchinson, Kansas.
Oh, okay. There's Cammy. Yeah, this is like the lobby here. The right flyer and a whole bunch of NASCAR stuff here. I bet you would like that. There's a gift store. We're going to test the rockets. It's a little darker.
See a postcard? Coming out of the door of concentration camp.
Yeah, I see the cards. Yeah, V1 missile here.
Okay, this is the German V2 V1 weapons that they've shown here, and they have a map showing all the locations where these missiles actually hit their targets.
What's over here? The link-up between the Apollo and the Soviet spacecraft.
Hi, I just put that music on for a little fun because we're in Kansas. Anyway, there's the Apollo spacecraft I was talking about. It's an excellent view of it. As myself and my son-in-law, my wife, they were taking a look at it, this particular bird. Now, this is the hallway. When you come in, there's a racing car there, an old one, and they have a lot of things on display. The thing that's difficult about taking photos in this place, it's very dark, and all the displays, the major displays, are behind glass, so your autofocus doesn't work too well, so you have to use manual or go back enough for the focus to still be in. It has a lot of neat things in there. I was surprised for being such a small museum. It's crammed in with a lot of stuff, but it doesn't look crowded. It looks very spacious, so it was amazing. It's a really good place to go if you just want to plan on seeing some aerospace instead of going. Maybe if you've been to Washington D.C. and Smithsonian, you might try coming down here. I've been to a lot of museums, and this has got to be the Cadillac of them. It it doesn't have a lot of stuff, but the things they do are spectacular. And the views are very, very, you can get up really close. Like I said before, the problem is the glass is in the way, and you can't take a real good close-ups because of that. You have to back up a little bit with your camera. And it is dark in there, so you have to make adjustments with your camera if you have one. What I did, I used a lot of Photoshop and try to get some of these photos right. And also, when I recorded this thing, there's adjustments on it, too, to make it lighter. But it's not perfect, and you can tell by the show, photos being. This is a Comet, the ME-163. They're going into the V-2 rocket and the German weaponry that they had back then. They have a statue there for the in honor of the concentration workers, the Jewish concentration workers that actually built these V-2 weapons. This is an internal view of the V-2 rocket, which is really neat. And you can see, I've never seen the internals of a V-2 rocket. And they have a map here showing all the locations where the, and this particular rocket shown here, and it had, they added fins to it, made it go a little further, and then they had a giant one they were building that had several, a couple of stages. It was going to reach New York. And here's one of the rocket planes that were done from the early days in the early 50s or 40s. And it was going beyond the speed limit. Not speed limit, but the speed of sound. Yeah, the early aircraft for that. And this particular two things, I don't remember what they are now because I've recorded this a long, long time ago. This was several years ago. I think it was 2012 or something. No, 2004, excuse me. So these are the views, but I saw some video from the another person that went recently. It looks like everything's pretty much the same. So if you go there, you'll really, really be surprised, and you'll be pleased with that. I have a lot of banners here. I can't remember quite where they are. I'll have to zoom into them later on and see what they are. And they have a replica of the Wright brothers plane here too. And this is a globe. And they have planetarium in there. We didn't stay for the show, but I'm sure it was excellent. I've seen the one in Los Angeles, so it's not observatory in Los Angeles, so it's not impressive for me. So small planetarium. Anyway, they're showing some rocket engines from the Saturn, and the projections about going to Mars. Again, with all the banners and pictures. This is the exit. I thought it had nice pictures of the flight. It didn't come out too well, but it is what it is. And this is the SR-71 research plane. And there's a portion of the space shuttle. And this thing, there's the SR-71 again, front view. And this is the space shuttle. That was also built by the company I worked for, Rockwell, and then it became taken over by Boeing. And there's Dr. Goddard's research. He's the one that started the first liquid fuel rockets. And they have another museum about him in New Mexico. I saw that one too. It was really good. This has come pretty much to the end of my presentation. Oh, there's a shark there. And this is, I can't remember if that's a Mercury, I think it's a Mercury one. There was a one astronaut deal. And this, I can't tell what this particular thing is. Now, there's a lunar lander here. The limb, and a couple of astronauts, a picture of them. Some more other things they have there if you want to see them. Again, I can't remember everything because it was too long ago. So, this is the end of my presentation. Well, thank you for watching, and I appreciate it. Goodbye.